Welcome to today's video. Today we're going to take you through to an exciting new gym, a new gym, King's Gym in Crawley, which is pretty sick. Firstly though, we have got my pre-workout, and then another pre-workout, which is not mine, this is Lewis's pre-filming workout. And then we also got the secret. So today I have to eat 850 grams of carbohydrate. So I've had one meal, and then I'm going to have three anabolic carb loading dates on the way to the gym as well. So we'll catch up with you when we get there. I'm a warrior. Okay, so I start training sessions when we're training chest, shoulders and triceps with calves instead of on leg day. Now what we're doing, what I do all the time is do single leg calf work, because like you'll find you have a big strength difference left to right, in particular if you're like me and you have flat feet. So this is a really good way to try and even out those weaknesses and imbalances. So really focusing on one leg at a time rather than the other. So here for example, my right leg will fail way before my left side. So it's why it's very important to try and break each side up individually, so you don't get any like overcompensation. Key again with calves is like form over everything. So don't think about the weight. You'll see how light the weight is here. And I was just explaining to Lewis, this calf raise is really heavy because most calf raises will load here at the front, like very close. Whereas this, the load's actually so far away from where we're working from. So from a leverage point of view, the weight is very heavy relative to what we're actually lifting. Okay, so we're here at King's Gym, obviously Crawley. Incline bench is a bit flatter than I'm used to. And it's got a very annoying bit where you can't rack the weight off as high as you want. But we'll get the scooters over with early. My shoulders feel horrendous, so we're gonna do a lot of warming up between each set as we go up. And then we'll look to do a working set, probably like 125-ish, and see what happens. Okay, so one of the things I'm focusing on is trying not to get limp wrist on the pressing. So what we're doing is using a band like this, elbows tucked in, grip the band, and then focus on twisting and rotating. Just try and get a grip fired up, wrists fired up, before we come into the main pressing movements, to try and help that strength in that position. The secret, if you've got terrible grip when it comes to benching, liquid chalk.
Yes, up. That's it, drive it up.
One thing you have to take into account sometimes is different equipment. The angle on that is very different than the one at physique. Probably like a 10 degree difference, so the strength comparison is going to be slightly different. So that's something like I always write down, excuse the shitty handwriting, but King's Crawley, so I know what gym I've done what in, so then I know what equipment I've used. makes a difference.
Last one, easy.
Oh, what's what?
You got it.
Right, up. Yes, drive it. Push.
Without tearing their peck off, I'd be very impressed. That handle, the back handle is one we want, but it's like deep, depth city.
Yeah,
okay, so what we're doing here, we're using the Viking, is that Viking press? I don't know, no, standard yeah. Chest press, what the hell you call it. So the reason we're using this is I'm trying to come like a neutral grip here, like very narrow, and I'm trying to force pressing through my triceps. As the rest of the machines here are all out here, I want to try and focus on that range of motion to really overload tricep pressing strength. So that's that wrapped up. Now we've got one more exercise for chest, which is going to be a deficit press up rest pause set, which could be like 10 minutes long in terms of a set. So we're going to go do that now on the top floor, and then get to the rest of the workout. Okay, so we've just moved the apparatus for the deficit press ups, and I now have just spotted the obvious mistake of why it felt weird. Can you spot the obvious there, Lewis? That one's fucking like 3 inches higher than the other one. That's normally I felt a bit twisted. So we'll correct that quickly and then we'll be good to go. It's gonna be a long set. Okay, so what we just did was a rest pause set on deficit press ups, and what I was trying to do was keep very controlled and negative and not just race through the reps. So I ended up doing like 19, 20 reps straight, and then we ended up doing sets of two, and there's still about 15 to 20 reps to go. So then I made defeat and went into women's press ups to get to the full 50 reps. Now, chest feels whammo from that. If you want a super safe way to take your chest to complete failure, that's a very good way to do it. Okay, so next up to wrap up the session, we're coming into an arm superset and a delt superset. So first we're going to do an overhead cable extension. The key of this is actually having this set up correctly. So you want the cable roughly at the height of your scapula, your shoulder blade. So that's pretty much in line there with where I want it to be in terms of my shoulder. And then what we're literally going to do is step away. For demonstration purposes. So we'll step away from the machine, put the cable overhead, and then it should be a straight line of force down towards the cable. So I'm getting a bit of elbow pain with this. I feel my elbow's inflamed. So you can't really see it now, but there you go. If I push in, see my tricep is like spasming slightly, but the tendons are very tight. So I'm just trying to take a bit of pressure out of that. And then probably just take this like very light, slow, controlled and through range on that left side, just to get through the range of movement. Now, the most important thing with an overhead extension, the money in terms of return on investment from the exercise is in the lengthened position, so when the cable is fully behind your head. So we really want to try and focus on spending as much time as we can there and then come up above as we come into extension. So this bottom part is really the most important bit. And then we'll just try and take out some pressure through my elbow and then we can hopefully train this injury free. Okay, so obviously for triceps we do the overhead. For biceps we focus on the brachialis and we're doing a single arm rope hammer curl. So advantage using the cable versus the dumbbell is we've got constant tension through the full range of motion, which is ideal for muscle contraction. And by training that hand position in that line of force, or there, we're focusing on the outside of our biceps. So that's a great alternative to the dumbbell hammer curl.
So I've got the new root band, and trying it compared to Aura Ring, that is very irritating on your wrist while doing this. The magic with this exercise is the bottom part here. Those first few inches of the movement from the bottom, really when you want to try and control it. So this is why this exercise is so good compared to like a dumbbell lateral raise, because at the bottom position here, I've still got lots of load, whereas if that's a dumbbell lateral, because gravity goes that way when you're standing up, you wouldn't have any tension. So it's a great way to really build side delts, get those really capped looking shoulders. Okay, so to finish off now, we've done side delts, we're going to do rear delts. So we're going to do a pull down, we're going to come slightly narrower, and we're going to focus on driving back through here, through our rear delt, not through our lats. So if you want to build bigger shoulders, this is a great exercise.
Here at King Gym in, well, I didn't say Croydon then, but obviously it's Crawley. So cool gym. Let us know what you think of the gym and if anyone else has trained here on the video, drop us a comment below what you think. Generally, I think it's pretty sick. Or they need more 20 kilo plates. Who uses 25 kilo plates? Now, on another side note, this is the first time we used the Whoop band. I put it on last night's first time. For some reason, it hasn't registered my weight training. Obviously, I didn't train hard enough. But I did register the cardio this morning on the elliptical trainer. So something that's quite cool, it's got my average heart rate and max heart rate. So 122 was my average heart rate, max rate, heart rate's 158. It said my duration was 44 minutes, I only did 30 minutes. So it's probably counting a lot longer than actually anticipated. But this is why I got this, because I've got an Aura Ring as well. But I just want to keep an eye on my heart rate when doing cardio. And actually I'm interested to see what it's like in terms of training. I have to say, I'm getting a bit irritated by this already in my wrist. So like at night, I consciously want to try and pull it off, which is why I didn't really like getting on with the Fitbit, but we have made it through 18 hours with it and we'll see how we get on with the rest of the week. So we'll keep posted on that. At the moment, still Aura Ring's the king, but the Whoop band tracks your heart rate. So that's what we put it, because I like data and cool stuff like that. So hope you guys found this video helpful, insightful. We've got a few more weeks of Operation Get Massive, and then there'll be time to get Shred City, and we have some exciting goals and plans coming up in the next few months, come up towards the end of the year. So if anyone can guess what they are, drop a comment as well below. I may or may not let you know if you're correct. And then please make sure you subscribe to the channel, smash the like button, and we'll see you next episode.